Hey guys, today we're gonna make this basic baby bib. You're going to need a 4.25 millimeter crochet hook, that's the size G. And you're going to need about 75 yards of worsted weight cotton yarn. You want to use cotton because it's absorbent, and if you use wool, you'll have to hand wash it. Don't use acrylic yarn. You're also going to need a button, a yarn needle that fits through your buttonholes, and a pair of scissors. Let's get started. All right, guys, so we're going to start out by chaining 13. So take your yarn, make a slip knot, insert your hook, and chain 13. When you have chain 13, you're going to skip the very first chain and half double crochet into each chain down the row for 12 half double crochets. And you half double crochet by yarning over on your hook, inserting your hook into the chain, pulling up a loop, yarning over, and pulling through all three loops on the hook. So just keep going down and doing a half double crochet in each chain. All right, so the end of each row, you're going to chain one and turn, but it's not written into the pattern. So just chain one and turn at the end of each row. So for round number two, we're going to do three half double crochets into the first stitch. This is an increase. So in this first stitch right here, you're going to half double crochet into it three times. So one, two, three. So you're going to increase by two stitches right there. And then you're going to half double crochet regular, just one in each stitch, until your very last stitch. Now when you're at the very last stitch, you're going to half double crochet three times into this stitch too. So one, two, three. And then chain one and turn. Now you should have 16 stitches, and for round three, we're just going to half double crochet every stitch. So just one half double crochet in each stitch, all the way down the row. All right, chain one and turn, and then for round four, we're going to do a basic repeat of round two. So in the first stitch, you're going to do three half double crochets in the same stitch, so an increase. And then you're going to half double crochet until the last stitch. And once you get to that very last stitch, you're going to do three half double crochets in that very last stitch. You should now have 20 stitches, and we're going to chain one and turn. And for round five, we're going to just half double crochet all the stitches. So just do one half double crochet in each stitch, all the way down the row. All right, now we're going to chain one and turn and do our last increase row. So you know the drill. In the first stitch, we're going to do three half double crochets. Half double crochet until the very last stitch. And when you get to the very last stitch, you're going to do three half double crochets in that same stitch. And now you should have a total of 24 stitches. So we're gonna chain one and turn. And now we're gonna do a bunch of rows of just regular half double crochet. So I'm going to do just half double crochet every stitch for seven rows. All right, so when you're done with those rows, you're going to cut your yarn, and I always just chain one for structure and pull through. Now we're going to switch to a new yarn. I can never decide which one to use. I think I'm going to use this purple color. All right, with the new yarn, we're also going to half double crochet every row. Yarn over on your hook twice, insert your hook into the stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, and pull through all three on your hook. That's how I start a new color in half double crochet. And now you're going to do three more rows of half double crocheting all the stitches, just using your new color. All right, I did four rows of half double crochet. For some reason, it looked a little small just doing three. And you can add more rows here if you want to make the bib longer. But now I'm going to work the button placket. And the button, where you place the button, is worked over basically nine stitches. So, chain one and turn, and you're going to half double crochet nine. Then chain one and turn. And you're going to half double crochet two together. So yarn over on your hook, insert your hook into the first stitch, pull up a loop. Insert your hook into the second stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, and pull through all the loops on your hook. So we're going down to eight stitches. And now half double crochet until the end. Chain one and turn. And now we're going to half double crochet until the last two stitches. And then we're going to half double crochet these two stitches together. Chain one and turn, and we're going to do our last button row. Half double crochet two together. And half double crochet until the end. And this is where we will put our button. Okay, so now you're going to single crochet or half double crochet all the way around. So we're going to start here, go down, all the way around to here. You can single crochet. I think I'm going to half double crochet just to give it a little bit more edge. So you want to go down this side, up and around. I've made it most of the way around all three sides, and I'm just going back up to the top. At the top, I'm going to do two half double crochets so that it turns. And then we're going to work our strap. So we're going to do nine half double crochets, nine half double crochets, chain one and turn. We're going to half double crochet two together. And then half double crochet until the end. Chain one and turn. And then for round three, we're going to do eight half double crochets. So half double crochet one time in each stitch down the row. Chain one and turn. Now we're going to half double crochet two together. And half double crochet down the row. Chain one and turn. And we're going to do two rounds of half double crocheting all the stitches. So round five, we're just going to half double crochet seven times, seven stitches. And half double crochet down the row for seven more stitches. So from here on out, there's going to be seven stitches in each row until I say. So we're going to half double crochet all the stitches one more time. And we're going to go on to row 7. So we're going to do 2 half double crochets in the first stitch. Half double crochet until the last 2 stitches. And then we're going to half double crochet these 2 stitches together. I'm going to chain 1 and turn. And half double crochet all the stitches. For round 9, we're also going to half double crochet all the stitches. Now we're going to go on to round 10, chain 1 and turn. We're going to half double crochet 2 together. Half double crochet until the very last stitch. And in the very last stitch, you're going to do 2 half double crochets in the same stitch. Chain 1 and turn. And we're going to half double crochet all the stitches. Round 12, chain 1 and turn. We're going to half double crochet 2 together. Half double crochet until the very last stitch, and then do 2 half double crochets in the same stitch. See how this is making a curve? Round 13, once again, is 2 half double crochet all the stitches. All right, now we're going to be making some sharp turns. So chain 1 and turn, and now we're going to half double crochet 3 together. So yarn over on your hook, insert your hook into the stitch, pull up a loop, insert your hook into the second stitch, pull up a loop, insert your hook into the third stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through all loops on the hook. Now we're going to do 3 half double crochets until the very last stitch. And in the very last stitch, you're going to do 3 half double crochets in the same stitch. And round 15 is to chain 1 and turn, and half double crochet all 7 stitches. All right, so now we're going to go down to 6 stitches on round 16, chain 1 and turn, and then we're going to half double crochet 3 together again, 1, 2, 3, and then half double crochet 1 in each stitch until the very last stitch. But in the very last stitch, we're only going to do 2 half double crochets in the same stitch. So this cuts us down to 6 stitches. And then we're going to chain 1 and turn, and we're going to cut down to 5 stitches. So in the first stitch, do 2 half double crochets in the same stitch. One half double crochet in the next stitch. One half double crochet in the next stitch. And then half double crochet the next 3 stitches together. Chain 1 and turn, and for round 18, you're going to half double crochet all 5 stitches. 1, 2, see how that is starting to lean? For round 19, you're going to do 3 half double crochets in the same stitch. One half double crochet, and then half double crochet 3 together. For round 20, chain 1 and turn, and half double crochet all stitches. 1. Now we're going to create the buttonhole. Chain 1 and turn. You're going to do 2 half double crochets, chain 1, skip this stitch, and do 2 half double crochets, make some place to put your button through. For round 22, chain 1 and turn. And you're going to half double crochet 2 together. Do 1 half double crochet in that middle stitch, and then half double crochet 2 together. We should have 3 stitches. Chain 1 and turn, and simply half double crochet 3 together. I like to chain 1 and then just slip stitch to make it neat. All right, so now we're going to single crochet down here and around this edge right here. Just to make it more smooth, or you can just go ahead and sew on your button and wear it. Now the last thing you have to do is apply the button. I just used some scrap yarn, and you gotta make sure your needle fits through your buttonholes. I like to go through each hole twice and tie it off after going through once, and then tie off again after going through twice. Then you're just going to weave in all of your ends and cut the yarn, and then you're done. Here's what it looks like on. Do you like your bib? My child just ate food and there's food in his hair everywhere. Let's see if we can get a better shot. What do you think, Reuben? I think it works.